Good evening, beautiful ladies and dashing gents on Sunday's evening with us, Blackout Gaming and TeamFortress.tv, with me, Jake, as one of your today's casters. We have something special for you, and we hope you're ready for the fantastic show that's going to happen in a couple of minutes. In one corner of the map, we have the unbeaten and the almighty, the scary SNSD, but do not fear, because in the opposite corner, we have the fierce Frenchman from Dota 2 willing to beat SNSD's end parts. Today we have special people as well. We'll be all trying to make your evening a bit more pleasant to watch, even though the hype for tonight's game has been building since semi-final match between the almighty Frenchman from Dota 2 and Power Gapers. As always, there's John flying with the all-seeing eye around the field, but wait, we have a special surprise for those who just turned in. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm introducing to you the one and only Hildreth. How is the weather looking out there?
The weather? Why would you want to know about the weather when inside we got TF2 on the computer screen? And you said that that wouldn't. You said that that would last like 25 seconds.
Yeah. Okay, so how do you feel? How do you feel about it? Sorry, I was just. It's just because.
You have to admit you pre-wrote that to everybody. Come on, it was quite an introduction though. I liked it. Anyway, it's good to be here on Team Fortress TV, secondary stream actually tonight with you tonight, Jake, the best Polish/British caster I ever worked with, and John from Blackout TV/gaming. Of course, we're casting Highlander, the ETFL Grand Final, ahead of a special night of TF2, because after this game there's a show match going on to raise awareness for I-49. That's going to be between Epsilon and High Roller Gaming. Epsilon, of course, the defending champions of ETF2L and Europe, unbeaten, and High Roller Gaming did the same thing at ESEA LAN. So that's going to be an exciting match to bring, and I hope you all get your checkbooks out, because I want to see that happening for real at LAN at the end of August. But tonight, and on this channel, that's going to be over at Team Fortress TV, by the way. The main channel, not this one. It's going to start in about an hour's time. But on this channel, we're going to focus on the Highlander. That's what we're here for. It's going to be Dara2 against SNSD. SNSD going for their fourth title, as you mentioned. ETF2L title.
Yes, exactly.
And Dara2 looking to upset the underdogs. And they met before, and I saw this game casted on Blackout Gaming. Regular season on Gravel Pit, and a lot of people thought Dara2 were going to upset the odds. But SNSD came out and played one of the strongest games I've seen them play ever, and beat them quite comfortably. Do you want to go through a bit about what happened on that night, if you remember? And, of course, probably more importantly, the teams and the maps.
From what I know is that SNSD had the upper hand during that night, and actually just won with Dara2 quite easily. I wouldn't call it a roll, but it was really hard victory over Dara2, over the Frenchman, and I'm pretty sure they will want to actually turn out the odds and show people that they're capable of beating SNSD, who actually didn't lose a single match this season. Am I right here? Because I'm not quite sure.
SNSD, they've never lost a single official match.
Exactly, it's just unbelievable. We'll see. We'll see if they happen. I mean, Dara2 will actually manage to do the impossible and beat and send SNSD for the first time.
Well, no team from Europe has ever done it. Of course, not mentioned there's I-40. Sorry, there's NAV EU Highlander show matches, but they were on New York servers, man. It doesn't count. It wasn't an official.
Yes, yes, I know. I've seen the pings when I was watching these games, and it was quite unpleasant for most of the players there. Maybe the next time we'll play on European servers and we'll see how Americans do.
Probably no better, but that's how it goes. But tonight, Dara2, they won 4 out of their 5 games, or won 8 maps or rounds, and they got 24 points. SNSD got 30 out of 30. So both teams obviously been the top two. Of course, there was that semi-final playoff you mentioned against Parrot Gapers that happened last week, and it was quite a close game.
It was a close game. I had the pleasure to cast it actually with Suddenly Star Mia, It was a really exciting match, really long as well. And Dara22 managed to win over Pirate Gapers 2-1 and secure the second place. So we'll see how it goes today. Really, I'm really eager to see Dara22 actually showing if they can beat SNSD. Also, I've heard that ALX is about to finish his game. This is his last game with SNSD,
yes,
at least.
Oh yes, I should mention. For those of you that didn't know, I did a Vanilla TV article, Vanilla TF2 article, where I interviewed Linus and Flippy just before the game yesterday, and Linus brought me the sad news that AOX is sort of losing interest in TF2 a bit, and this is going to be his last game for SNSD. So, you know, that's the original Highlander heavy retiring.
Yes, one of the best heavies I've ever seen, if not the best.
Well, and one of the things about him is he's the most influential. You can argue whether he's the best or not. There's a lot of good American heavies, but he's certainly one of the most influential people. And he's one of the few people that brought attention to the heavy class. So it's a sad day for TF2 to see him go.
Yeah, he showed people that heavy is capable of doing some ridiculous stuff, as you probably seen that in the frag video of ALX that John was playing on that stream. All I gotta say is just this match is a huge tribute to ALX, and it's really hard to see him go. He's one of the best heavies I've ever seen. And I would really like to play him once, maybe in the future. Maybe he actually will get back to the TF2. We'll see. But for now, it's his last match, so he's probably going to do some really, really interesting stuff.
Well, there's a bit of pressure on SNSD tonight, of course. So if you just want to go through the maps quickly, there's all payload maps to start with. Like, I'm surprised that there wasn't a pick, like they didn't pick Gullywash or Lakeside, because during the regular season, SNSD managed to scrape a win on Gullywash against Parrot Gapers and Lakeside. They were 2-0 down at one point, but then they came back and won the game 3-2. So yeah, they look like they might be slightly weaker on those maps, and Dara22 could be slightly stronger, being that a lot of them are very high-level sixes players. Like, you've got the Dara22, if we go over a quick look at the lineup, you've got, you know, ex-punchline players like K3 on Medic, Tech playing the heavy, he's playing with RLM in Prem these days. Of course, you've got Flippy on Sniper, 6 Sniper, T-Mac playing for Crackland these days on Soldier. Got Deegon, who used to play for Pyrogen, I think, before they went to Prem. Exon, the Demon Man, the French Demon Man mastermind. And I can't remember who I'm missing. Who am I missing from that team?
Daff?
I probably haven't mentioned Daff.
Yes.
Daff and Mister.
Yeah, he's just going to probably show today some exceptionally good stuff, because he was also looking up to this game. He did amazingly against Pirate Gapers last week. So we'll just see how it goes. Just everything will happen in the near hour or two. Depends if we get to watch the third round, which is, as far as I know, Barn Blitz.
Yeah, that's an interesting choice. I mean,
all payload maps, as you said, all payload maps are just going to be fast forward, sticking to the cart, tactics as well. All those maps are stock.
Stock, did you mean? Or Spock?
Yes.
I thought you said Spock for a second.
Spock, yeah, we can like throw a Star Trek in here, I guess, but it's just, you know, kind of the size of battle of in a Star Trek or Star Wars as well, if there are any sci-fi fans there. It's, you could easily just, you know, trying to get this game.
Might be better if you just stop talking about Spock and Star Trek.
No, but it's just, you know, it's stock maps, which is like people are very used to these. They played on pubs a lot. They played on lobbies on pogs. They screamed these maps thousands of times. So,
yeah, Barn Blitz is sort of less of a well-known payload map. Of course, you've got the two main staple maps, Badwater and Upwards, which we'll see Upwards after this map. Then you've got sort of Swiftwater, which isn't played in Europe, and Barn Blitz. I think it's a really interesting choice, mainly because I don't like the map very much. I think it's slightly broken. It's not as good as the Upwards or Badwater, but hope, you know, maybe it won't go that far. Who knows what will happen? I'd rather have seen Kofmak decide it. That's what the teams have picked, as we're waiting for someone from Daratutu to come online. They are missing their... It looks like Scout... I think it's Plapla that they're missing?
I think so.
Here he is on the server now. Plapla, of course, used to play for Punchline as well. Just a rundown of the SNSD team, Jake. We have the Sucker playing Medic. He's going to be switching to Heavy next season, apparently.
Wow.
And
Flash.
That's huge. Flash is going to come in as Medic. He's played Medic before for SNSD during Season 2.
Mm.
We have AOX is going to be Heavy, obviously. Cube is going to be on Engineer. Kalis, the Demoman Extraordinaire. Tweak, the Hacking Extraordinaire on Sniper from Greklan. Hurry, the Spy. There's a bit of pressure on Hurry in this game, I think, as a Spy. Going against Staff, Drozo on Scout. Linus, the team leader and captain on Soldier. And Buttnose.
Okay.
Or just Buttnose on Pyro.
Yeah. Buttnose. Let's see if he will drop the Uber as Pyro. If we go over to Daratutu, I'll try to remember because I don't really have any roster wrote down. So Flippy's on Sniper is going to snipe those heads. The Gun is on Pyro. He showed exceptionally good skill in Paragippers last week. Agazon is the Demo Man. K3 on Medic. Daff is going to click on backs. Tech is going to be the good pair for ALX. Mist is going to sit on Engineer. T-Mac, I do believe he's going to play on Soldier, and we're just missing Plapla, who is going to scout round and look up for those drops.
Yeah, now talking about tactics, it looks like SNSD will be attacking first, and I think the guy to watch has to be Kalis on the doing the suicide, his pattern of suicide with the sticky jumper. He jumps behind, then he will jump back in and try and sync it with his team. It's usually very successful for SNSD, and the Sucker will probably spend the first minute, 2 minutes, depending on how long, in the spawn.
Yeah, it's
before he does anything. And Daratutu need to know this is coming, so we are going live right now then.
Looks like it. So, ladies and gentlemen, welcome again to TeamFortress.tv. My name is Jake. Today with me is Hildreth and John streaming. We are watching SNSD versus Daratutu, the grand finals of Season 4, powered by Blackout Gaming. So, it's just, you know, everything will happen today. That's what I was saying since the beginning of this cast. We'll just see what will happen today, and I hope we'll see some ridiculous stuff from both teams.
That's true, as we're into the setup. Daratutu on defense first, SNSD on offense. It will only be best of one, I have to say, due to teams not wanting to play best of three. It could last 3 hours. It's, you know, it's not going to be quite as epic, but it kind of does make a bit of sense. SNSD choosing to attack first, which is what they feel comfortable doing, attacking first. So my eye is on Kalis. What is he going to do? With a sticky jumper, I'm assuming.
Just waiting for that one jump.
I'm looking at him right now, putting two, three stickies. He's gonna go, yep, here he goes behind. Flippy is dead, actually, sorry, that's Deadring Spy. Kalis is getting challenged by a soldier, they knew he was coming. And T-Mac has jumped him, but Kalis dukes him and then he jumps back to spawn. He's not doing anything. Meanwhile, Flippy gets two body shot kills. And now Kalis goes in looking for the medic. He gets denied and. It's interesting positioning from K3. He's decided to sit in that shed, and the first kill actually for SNSD goes down. Tweak, the hacker, the carrier, taking Mister, so that engineer, that sentry has no NG on it, and it's going to get spammed down and taken down by SNSD.
So it looks like for the beginning, Kalis is just trying to drop the medic, but he's not successful in that. He's been gunned down by Tech pretty easily and shut down. Right now, K3 is kind of safe. They lost the sentry on the cliff there, but he's just really safe. He's just dodging, he's just crouching, trying not to get headshot by Twig. Buttnose is just guarding him from any spies or whatsoever, and the Sucker is still holding in spawn. He doesn't want to risk a drop. That will be the first drop of today, but goes to pop from K3. They're trying to pull those people away from the sentry. They need to get this their engineer a bit of time to build up the sentry. Yeah, and we're gonna see the sucker just going out of the spawn in any second now, actually.
Yeah, and that was Kadus switching to Sneaky Jam before Zebra really easily. And now that they have that Uber, and they're going to push back in. Exxon actually suicided to try and get the Force, and now here comes T-Mac trying to get the Force. The sucker holds onto it, and now he pops onto Kadus. T-Mac's taken down, and the Pyro does air blast them out. Exxon actually took the teleporter and almost died, and Daratutu are going to lose this point and lose, like, five players from that. And SSD are going to cap this point and push straight into the roof. Kadus with an aggressive jump, supported by his team, AOX, Buttonos, but the high ground belongs to Daratutu. Wow, yeah. Tweak just snipes K3, and that's big Uber advantage again to SSD, Jake.
Yeah, Sucker's currently standing on 60%. He's stuck in on that car. The whole team actually is just stacking that one bomb there. Looks like Daratutu is trying to regain the control over the roof, but the point is already lost because of how many points on how many people are actually stacking it. Eventually Tech go down, but there goes a nice drop by Flippy. I do believe that was a drop.
Yeah, you do like to bring attention to the circus drop. What kind of sick man does that? Bring attention to a medic dropping the Uber in his worst moment. But yeah, he did get the drop, but the sucker generally had no reason to pop it in that position. He had to risk it. They did have Uber advantage, but it's not going to stop SNSD getting second, but it does give Daratutu a great chance to put a defense up on third. That was actually a really big snipe, as some pressure is trying to come in from the SSD players, non-mid, but they couldn't get in. Daratutu holding the doors really, really well right now, and they're trying to go for this sentry build in the window and hold really, really close, keep their soldier and scout on the top right to deny Tweak from peeking. Tweak is actually going to get chased down by Plapla. No, he's managed to run away, but Plapla still walks through and kills Tweak, and now he's onto AOX. But
that's not going to work out. Daratutu are currently holding the little shed there with the health packs. They do not want any blue players out there. They're holding on that 100% Uber, but the sucker is almost 100. Yes, he is right now. He just hit that 100% mark. He's holding back near the teleport in that little toilet house. He doesn't want to risk it to Flippy. ALX goes down to eggs on nice pipes there from the little shed.
Kadus with the bomb. Ooh, takes out K3, and there's a drop Uber. I could see SSD were planning to try and force Uber before they did anything, and now SSD look like they want to push this in straight away. Are they going to let up? That's the question.
Wow, that was amazing drop there by wow, I can't even believe what that was. You just jumped. Yes, you just jumped and just got the kill. It's like simple as that. Two drops already for both teams, one each. So the point is already being capped. It's going to be 3 points for SNSD currently. They want to push this far away because the sentry is still level one on the last point there. K3, he doesn't have his Uber yet. He's building it pretty fast. He's already in 50%, with Sucker is holding on to that 30. So they need that little advantage there so they can counterpop if they need to.
Yeah, there was a bit of trash talk going on in the chat after K3 dies. Kadus made a bit of a comment there, and K3 didn't take too blindly for it. Just too kindly to it, sorry, but it's so hard to play Melee in Highlander. You can drop to literally anything. Kadus just flew from the air, sticky pipe combination, it was perfect. But SST still have to push this point equal Ubers. Now, how will they break this defense? This is the toughest point to push on this map. I think it's certainly a case about controlling the high ground. And
about sentry positions, basically, and trying to maintain that level 3 at all times.
Yeah, using the level 3 either as a tool to just take focus away from their team or distract the Uber. And here's an Uber through the map room. The sucker's dropped down, but the rest of their team don't get in. AOX actually gets dropped instantly. The sucker's rotating through map room. He's alone against Daff. Gets an Uber saw onto Daff. Two Uber saws. Where the sucker, sorry, one, and Daff actually gets... activates his dead ringer by hurry stabbing him. So the sucker does get out alive, and there's lots of kills have come in meanwhile from the rest of the team pushing in. They're taking the sentry out, and here's the repush from SNSD. AOX with the cleanup as he usually does. Four up for Daratutu. Exxon can't do anything. right now, I think they're going to get this point. Yeah. Need some big plays.
Nothing going to happen here. Only three players up, including the medic, Flippy and Axon. Not so much offensive classes. K3 goes down, and there goes the first cap of the game. SNSD wins the first round of this. 6 minutes and 19 seconds. Really nice time for Bad War. It's going to definitely be hard for Dara2 to push it in that time.
Yep, bud. I agree with that, and I think SNSD just playing very, very solidly and aggressively there. The whole time I was watching the sucker trying to escape, I didn't pay any attention to what was happening in the main fight. And it looks like somewhere, somehow, Dara2 just got overwhelmed by the repush. Because what SNSD like to do with their push is sort of get their combo in, trade Ubers, and then run up the stairs and go back into the map room. Which is a really interesting way of pushing the last. I've not seen it before from any other team. Of course, yeah, AOX got dropped during the Uber. He got headshot and wrangled down. So that didn't pay off. But Kaders must have done some real big work or something without the Ubers. And yeah, along with the rest of his team sinking in. I apologize, I didn't see that.
Yeah, this drop actually bought SNSD's third point, I'd say. But here we go, and the gates are down. Demo jumps behind Axon, trying to get some stuff, but he gets caught off, and he's really low on health. He's not gonna do anything. He's on 2 HP right now. He's hiding behind that rock, trying to lob some stickies, but they're not gonna work. Simply just gonna get picked off. And I think that didn't work out quite well. Medic's still holding on to that Uber quite safely. There's some spam on the sentry as well, trying to take it down as soon as possible. It's being flushed out by SNSD. They are standing still. That goes the pop though. Sucker head to pop. I didn't notice
that. They traded the Ubers. Obviously, wow. They saw their combo in the tunnel, and Kaders just asked for the sucker to drop down on him and use the Uber. So they traded Ubers, and it hasn't worked out particularly well. They're taking loads and loads of damage here in this top right position. They've lost a few players. It's a tricky part of the fight. Tweak gets a kill on Exon, and AOX is dropping down to defend the cart. He kills Tech, the heavy fight there, and he cleans everything up on the cart. So that's a nice little move to reclaim the low ground. But now they need to fight for the high ground. As this is a big soldier bomb coming in, no actual frags from it.
Yeah, so they need to hold that tunnel area right now, because the cart is already out of the tunnel, and Sentry is not really watching that area, so basically what I see is the rest of the team is trying to hold the tunnel, try to pick off players while the Sentry is watching the cliff. There goes the pop though on Pyro! KT pop on Pyro, there's Pyro the gun trying to get people off the roof, off the cliff I'd say even, gets the sentry down. There goes the counter pop from the soccer on the scout.
Wow.
Because he didn't have anyone.
Wow,
Kaders 3k with, wow.
Including the medic, especially huge pipes there, Kaders, but they are going to lose the first point just because of the way the spawns come in, but it does give SNSD a great chance to hold the roof. Kaders needs to just get back up into position as quickly as possible. And they have a 40% foot Uber charge right now.
This was insane. Kaders is definitely having his day today. He dropped medic once, and now he got 3k. I do believe it was like one pipe, two pipes, one pipe. It was insane.
There is a lot of pressure on the cart right now from Dara2-2, and there's a jump in. Sucker actually gets taken down by a level 2 sentry that was cleverly placed, so that's a really, really good non-Ubered push from Dara2-2 right here to claim the second point. There are people behind on the roof as well now. SNSD kind of falling apart a little bit. AOX and Droza made a play for the medic, where Linus comes in from behind and drops K3 again. He was so close to Uber. That was a huge kill on the medic. They are probably going to lose the third point, but they will be able to have equal Ubers to defend the last point. And yeah, now it's going to be about 3 minutes to attack last. For Dara2-2.
As soon as the just got the respawn, so it's going to be a bit more easy to them to hold actually last, but they already lost third. There's absolutely nothing they can do about that. The whole blue team is holding that area. But they're trying to be a bit more aggressive, trying to buy their engineer, who is Cube, I do believe, some time to build up the level 2 sentry currently. Only demo, only Axon on the car, trying to think of what to do. K3 is on 48 Uber, while the sucker is on 70, so they will have that counter pop ready.
I'm just looking at this defensive scene. Non-Uber pressure comes in again from Daratutu, look, they've got through the choke point without taking that much damage, actually. And they're spreading all over SSC. SSC are going to be have to be forced to use Azuba defensively. And here they go, using the K3 drop down for some reason. I have no idea why, but SSC is still losing players. T-Max got like a 2k somewhere. Eryx is stuck in a corner, trying to fight off Tech alone on the cart. He gets killed with an NG, but it's just Exon and Tech and C-Mac
only
on the cart.
Only two players up. Only two players up for SMSD.
Cube, it's just Cube. The sucker coming in with the Ubisoft. He can't do anything to stop it. But there's a Tweak defending the cart. Oh, it's Tweak against T-Mac right now. And but he gets it in the end. And SMSD lose the first map. This reminds me of the game from a while ago between Colony and SSD in the Experimental Cup final, where they lost the first map to Colony and came back. But Daratutu surprisingly taking the first
map. Such a fast time, actually. 6 minutes 19 seconds is a very fast time for Badwater, but Daratutu, I think they had like 2 minutes, minute and a half left, which is enough to actually for two Ubers if you play well.
Yeah.
That was an insane play by Daratutu. They actually used that third point after they wiped out SNSD on second and pushed it to last. They didn't allow SNSD to build up their defenses quick enough.
What I really like about that, Jake, was the way they pushed non-Ubers. They didn't show any respect or wait for Uber. They just went for it. I mean, K3 died, but they forced an SNSD Uber. And they got many frags, and
they got
after
the sentry down. They got the sentry down in the meanwhile, so it allowed them to actually be more aggressive. Exxon dropped down. Tech got dropped down on the car to fight them off, but he didn't have any heals. He didn't have any cover, so he just got down. Only two players up there. They couldn't do much. Medic and I do believe sniper. So there's nothing you can do when there's a heavy and demo on the cart.
So now then, the question is, can Daratutu do it and beat SNSD and become the first team to beat them in Europe? I mean, SNSD have lost maps before in finals.
But as you said before, they haven't lost a match.
They've lost like a round of Gravel Bit in the regular season once to May Contain Nuts. That's it.
That's still a very nice score, I'd say. Really, nothing to be ashamed of. But for now, Daratutu is leading with 1-0 for SNSD, and we're currently on upward after Badwater round. Again, this is TeamFortress.tv with Jake Hildreth and John on camera. If you're wondering what is going on, it's Highlander and Premier Division 1 of Season 4, powered by Blackout Gaming.
Of ETF2L.
Of ETF12, of course. How could I forget? Oh my god.
Yes.
Possibly. Jesus. I'm terrible.
Don't worry about it, Jake.
I'm terrible, really. But we'll see what happens right now. Daratutu is definitely having the upper hand. SNSD need to play more aggressive if they want that third round to be going on. Upward. What do you think about Upward? I personally very like it. It's a long map, it's well designed, even though the spawn is basically in the middle there. The whole map is basically one big spiral, as far as I know. And it's quite long, so you have enough time to get some nice pushes.
I really like this map for Highlander. But I think it goes down as being the buggiest map ever made in TF2, and it's probably been the amount of fixes and for all the bugs that they used to have, but as far as some league play goes, a lot of the glitches are very
easy
to, you know, are banned. But I really like this map's design. It's the main thing. Like the first point is the first point is sort of a big wide open space, but there's the sight lines aren't too bad, and then you've got this hill for the second point, which gives the attackers options in the high ground. I mean, it is a bit of a sniper frenzy on the second point. The third point is this long climb up, so it gets harder and harder for the attackers as each point goes by, which I think a map should be like. But there's also enough options.
We are already live. That was quick after the first round, which was actually pretty quick because it took under 15 minutes. We already started the second round, which is an upward, of course. We'll see where... I think who's on defense first? I think it's SNSD, as Cube is setting up his defenses in the regular spot on the hill, watching out for all jumpers and people that are trying to get behind the medic. We'll see also where the sucker decides to hold up with ALX.
Yeah, that's true. I expect Esnesteam probably to give this point up fairly quickly. What I see from here is a massive, massive amount of space being given. This is something I don't really like about European Islanders. This first point in upwards, the style is generally not to defend it as hard as the second point.
Yeah, exactly. It's just too open for people to actually defend this. The defense in first is just as basically in any payload, that's just
giving them a
waste.
Point for free, yeah. Really, which I don't like, but Plarply instantly gets sniped, and that's the only frag that's gone down. It looks like some of the SNSD players are sort of setting up for some sort of ambushes. There's a play on the sentry by Daff, which easily gets countered. Do you see anything? It's just cart pushing and cautious
nothing.
Play.
Nothing.
Very,
it's
very
just
cautious
both
play.
Both teams are just waiting for the other team to make a move.
Sneaky jumper out there. He's going to try and make a play. He's been spotted by Linus. He's also running the lock and load, so he's running Ooh. Into the tunnel completely unspotted. And Tweet gets backstabbed by Daff. That's a big kill. Linus is El Hurry with a double kill onto K3 and the Pyro. I wasn't watching that at all.
Yes, he got a nice stab there on the beginning.
It's
like,
first
the
time we've seen Hurry in this game, and he's been under a lot of pressure in terms of like a lot of the players in the scene don't really rate him as a spy, but he went pretty big there, giving the uber advantage for his team on for SNSD. So now SNSD need to do something about stopping the cart. They've dropped really, really far back. They're holding in the window room right now.
Yeah, looks like SNSD is just holding in that balcony area, trying to play safe. ALX gunning down every single person trying to come up there. There goes a nice stab by Hurry on Tech, but heads
down
Linus to T-Mac.
Wow, Linus trying to get on the medic there, but K3 was out of there very, very quickly. Yeah, it looks like they're just gonna wait for Daratutu to get the Uber and push into them, because sometimes SNSD would like to push out with their Uber advantage, but Daratutu are taking no chances. They're way far back building Uber.
Yeah, they just really want to play this cautious. They're piling on the medic so he doesn't get picked off. I see like three, four classes on the medic. It's quite ridiculous. So much protection for the medic. They know that SNSD is capable of dropping the medic.
This is where you've got to really watch the snipers as Kadus comes in and drops K3. If K3 was really close to Uber, he had it, I don't know. And this is going to be a good defense for SNSD. So now I'm just going to put the cam on either Tweak or Flippy and see what they can do. That's what I'd be watching right now.
Sniper Ballast Thick and Flippy, one of the best snipers in Europe. That said, that's official. So both sniper fights. The fight is just going to be interesting. Just Fick is trying to get a nice snipe on K3, but he didn't manage to. The combo for SNSD is still holding in that balcony area. They're trying to. Daratutu is trying to get in. There goes Tech, and he gets down ALX. He put a lot of damage on the sucker, but he manages to get out with 100 health. Tech is really aggressive, trying to get a lot of picks. Nice work there. He's basically alone without any medic.
Yeah, Linus actually bombed over the top and picked K3, but look at this non-Ubered pressure. They killed almost everybody from SNSD despite that. And Mister is on the car trying to cap it as the hero NG actually takes Cube down with the shotgun, and it's just the sucker and Linus, and they're out of there. Great non-Ubered push from Daratutu. Yeah, but is Uber advantage for SNSD as Kadus and the sucker are running away. Tech is pushing up. He wants to force this, but Kadus wants to go in, and they've used this Uber, but K3 is way out of there. They're going to flash Drozo in there and try and chase this medic, but the medic is so safe right now. Drozo is going to try and chase. He can't do anything. He gets picked. It's a sucker that gets taken down by Exxon, and this defense is crumbling a little bit for SNSD, but this is a long, long climb, this third point, and Tweak is still up. Look at that. Two kills already for him already.
Yes, as soon as he... just gunning down Flippy, so there won't be counter snipe for Twig right now. He's just going to stand still and, you know, enjoy the view. Looks like Linus wanted to drop K3 right there, but he didn't manage. There goes the pop though, flashing Demo and Heavy, but they're not really doing anything with it. Demo jumps down on the sentry, but he's being gunned down. He didn't do absolutely jack nothing. right now. Looks like Tech and K3 are in the drop down with the gun, trying to
Oh, Daff takes down AOX and Kadis. Huge backstab from Daff. I was about to say, Jake, as you were talking there, we need Daff to do something right now, and he's just done it. I think he's going to win them that point. It's just this wrangled sentry to deal with right now.
In the first round, we didn't really see both spies working, but right now, Hari just nice drops in the beginning. Now, Daff stabbing the combo, basically, almost. It's going to be a nice defense there. I hope to be a nice defense, but the suckers on 100%, they lost their sentry, so they are pushed back to the last point, which... I don't know, it's really hard to say if that's difficult or not to defend. It's quite an open area, and I do believe we have a pause.
Yes, we do, and it's a very... most interesting time to pause ever, because I'm watching Deagon airblast his stickies and they are flying everywhere. I mean, it's scary to be Deagon right now.
But it looks majestic, I have to say.
Yeah, but 65% Uber advantage for SNSD, and K3 is quite close here. If they could choose to push into them here, although Kadus and AOX seem to be far back, Buttnose is up front now. They could choose to push in with the Uber advantage.
I'm just looking at the chat in the STV on the server, and people are just saying adios the gun. They all just see the death of that poor Datutus Pyro. If they manage to kill him right now, they can actually push out with that Uber and hope for the best. But K3 is playing really safe today. He doesn't want to take any chances, even though he dropped, I do believe, twice today. On upward, I mean. He wants to play it safe because he knows what Kadis, what Linus and Drozo are capable of. And really, I didn't see any work from Linus and Drozo as well so far on K3.
Linus has got one kill on K3 so far in this map. But yeah, people are saying that they pause at the end of the round. That's not necessarily true, because these days in TFT you can pause. You can request a pause whenever you want. And 95% of the teams would say yes.
So yeah, because we just want to see a nice sportsmanship from both teams, and usually I'm not against pauses, and no one is, because sometimes happens some really various stuff. For example, I think John is saying right now that some of the players on the server right now are lagging, so they wanted to figure this thing out. Oh, there's go on pause. That the gun didn't die. He didn't die to the sticky trap there. He managed to survive that, so there won't be any push from the sucker they're hoping for to drop the.
Look how far
KP.
The cart is being pushed, though. It finally does get cleaned up, and it does look like Daratutu are trying to push into this upper ground, and the Uber's forced from SNSD. Deagon denies it as a pyro. Now he's chasing the medic because they ice skate around. He runs into a pyro. Tech drops down onto the cart. He gets focused down. And K3 gets body shot by Tweak through the tiniest of gap, and Exxon manages to take down the sentry just before he gets sniped by Tweak, and Tweak takes down the pyro on the car as well. So overall, a good defense by SNSD for now, but I've said that three times already and they've instantly gone and lost the point the next time around. So let's see what happens. Like, this is the point where people were starting to say a couple of them were lagging.
Yes, and, yes.
I do apologize for the broken HUD, by the way. There's nothing we can do about it. It will fix itself when
Once it's fixed itself. But we don't see any more people escaping right now on the field. The cart is going back, actually, so yeah, Death is just gonna touch it so it doesn't get back too far and can give some people cover. But right now, SNSD is just holding that balcony area, that staircase there, because this is probably the safest place to hold with the combo. Basically, most of SNSD people are holding there, but there's this push there to trying to get some picks out of it. I don't know if that wasn't a force, but
They went straight for the medic with the Uber advantage. It was a purposely matched play, but Kadis obviously got blasted into the pit, but K3 still died. But There's only three up right now, SNSD, and this is trouble right now. There's a couple of spawns are coming in now, including Kaedus. The sentry is still up. They need to get the sentry. Flippy snipes. Snipes the sucker, but hurry, backstabs the medics. And now it's all in the DM fight right now. It's three versus seven.
Tech drops down. Tech drops down. They are trying to get some nice kills, but kills everyone. I'm trying to get... Buttnose goes down as well, and both Pyro, Engineer, and Spy push the cart to the pit, and everything blows up. 7 minutes, 30 seconds.
Yeah, that's a good, decent time. That's the time for the championship as well. You have to remember, there are two seasons. If they can cap this, sorry, defend for 7 minutes and 29 seconds, they will be champions of EGFL.
And that will be the first time in the history that SNSD lost to someone and in the finals. So they're looking for a come up to this. They really want to have their something.
I really just want to compliment their play, because they are playing really well. Even though they lost their medic to... you know, their uber advantage, they still manage to get some kills, and most teams will, when they lose their medic, will just crumble and, you know, die all at the same time and everything. But they were 2-2, they didn't happen for them. They got enough kills to sort of make an entrance and attack the point.
I just have to say that even though K3 dropped quite a few times, Dartutu are exceptionally good at pushing without ubers. They don't really care about counter pops. They just go in and get their job done.
They know about the fact that the defense has such disadvantages with spawns, so people are not afraid to throw their life away. Basically, not afraid to attack. They go in and they fight and they use their teammates' distractions. As SNSD are attacking, trying to keep their crown. They have to cap this point in 7 minutes and 10 seconds and counting. There was the attempted suicide play onto the medic. Kaedus actually died to a sticky trap, I think, as he came out.
And there was already 4 or even 5 kills for Daratutu right there. Nice sticky traps, nice defense with that sentry being a bit more offensive on the left, or looking from the red spawn side of cliff. But there we go, Kaedus behind enemy lines with a sticky jumper trying to get something done, but he gets spotted by Daft trying to gun him down. Still, Kaedus trying to do something behind enemy lines, but in the meantime, SNSD managed to push the card in about a minute in the first point, so Daratutu need to get back.
Kaedus is just jumping behind him, and there's like 3 or 4 people focusing him. It's crazy. They're so scared of him.
Yeah, they're he's just wasting their time, basically, allowing his team to push the cart with any problems, without any problems.
Fortunately, SSD can't push without him, because he's their main attacking force, but they have got this ground and the first point, but they still have to break an Uber, and there's still a reasonably strong defense going up from Daratutu right now. As Kaedus respawns and he's going to get back into the position. Here comes the push. A Flippy takes down Tweak and the sucker drops to a backstab from Thaf. That's a really, really big kill.
That was right so close. That should be a push, but right now the Dav just rescued his team from inevitable, at least counter pop. So K3 is holding on the 100% Uber safely, and he doesn't have to pop it.
It's the worst time to lose your medic just before you're going to push. Your team's like, okay, we're going to Uber onto them. Oh, wait, we can't do it anymore. And instantly, Daratutu reacted and cleaned up the rest of their team. So now we're going to see a non-Ubered push from SNSD. They're the type of team that will do this. The risk here is if they lose the sucker during the push. Kaedus is backstabbed instantly by Daff. And the sucker's building with Drozo. On 50%, there's 5 minutes 10 seconds on the clock here.
They really need to hurry up. But there was Daff again. Linus goes down to another backstab. He's there right next to ALX. Doesn't know what's going on. He gets down. No, he's still alive. He's still behind enemy lines. Daff is working on that blue team right now. Nice headshot from Flippy on Kaedus. Again, Kaedus goes down. So it's going to significantly make SNSD push difficult.
There was an Uber force there. I didn't know who got the force. I wasn't paying attention, but somebody forced an Uber.
But that allowed 100% K3 Uber. Yeah, and Tech just basically walk into the balcony area, so they will have a bit more cover there. But there's 100% Uber, as you said, Uber advantage there. There goes the pop on Kaedus trying to get some stuff done, but the gun is just basically blocking that Uber push. Just really nice.
Yeah, he wasted it. Really good job by Digon. IOX wasn't with his with his teammates there, and he actually gets taken down by Tech as well. Tech standing strong. Exxon with the triple kill on the cleanup.
Wow!
Kadis got killed behind by the engineer. It's a fatal push for SNSD with 4 minutes left on the clock. Tweet gets a snipe on Flippy. Hurry is
they
behind.
They really need to hurry up, as I would say. Hurry needs to work on that sentry there, but the gun doesn't allow him to go anywhere
it's near.
It's near
impossible, isn't it? That push was textbook like mistakes in Highland. I think the pressure is getting to them a little bit. Like you don't push into a pyro with a demo by himself. But here comes Linus with a bomb, takes out the engineer, and now this sentry is going to go down AOX in the window. Kadis around the corner, getting spammed. T-Mac has an attempted bomb on the sucker.
That was nearly getting the sucker there, but he got spotted in the last second, and a butt nose got him out. It goes counter pop from K3 actually pop just to slow them down a bit, but it's not gonna do anything.
He gets picked as well by Tweak. I don't agree with that decision. They were thinking, should we defend the car? Shouldn't we? Should we? And then they made the decision too late, and it was just on Tech. Tech couldn't do anything with the Uber, and K3
Tweak
dies
again on
as well. Look at this momentum change, Jake.
Yes, it's like 3 minutes left and the car is being pushed heavily by the scout. They're pushing in with the Uber. Their Uber popped. Sentry goes down. Exxon goes down. Teammate goes down. Half of the team from Adara to 2 is dead.
They need to kill on K3 right now. That's the most important. They were going to get third point for free, but someone has to chase K3 up top. He's alone.
K3 is not building Uber as well, and Sucker already surpassed him with 30%.
Yeah, someone needs to chase him. Kadis is trying to wander up there, but K3 actually gets sniped by Tweak. Huge play.
Oh, and he gets missed as well.
Engineer.
The engineer, yes, goes down for a Dara 2-2. So this is going to be a really interesting moment because they're already stacking the card. They really need to cap this card as soon as possible because they have upper hand
right
now.
Exxon, the King Boys behind.
Oh, 3-kill.
Wow,
oh,
Exxon.
My God.
Eggs on there, or could he have saved his team there? They were 70% Uber disadvantage. You just walk through the tunnel on the left there, Jake.
Oh,
and they're actually
going
to defend the car here. Oh, T-Mac is going to attempt to. He's getting ping-ponged in the air. It's like watching someone on the bouncy castle there. But he goes down. S2C are going to push in on Uber. They've got enough kills to do it. Kadis coming in against Tech. Tech is really weak. Well, he's not that weak. Been dropping down. Exxon tried to jump on the up top, but he fails, but he still gets loads of damage. Nobody focused Exxon, and Exxon cleans everyone up on the cart. But they do get the medic.
Oh, Hori gets down! I mean, Hori kills K3. K3 goes down to Hori. Nice step there. It's going to get Sassina's the upper hand right now. Sucker is on 70%, a minute and a half left on the clock. They still have a lot of players. Dartutu is half dead. So they need to stack the card right now.
Yeah, they need to get on it. It's so close to Uber. This is the problem with when you get with this point, and when you get kills, and you need to wait for Uber to attack the point because it's so hard to attack. And here they go. Kadis, Uber's. He's got to get on the sentry. He's getting spattered back so far. He can't do anything. They're desperately trying to focus the sentry. They can't get it down. Linus jumps up in the end. There was a cleanup. T-Mac came in from the flank, cleaned up the combo, but it's a 5-4 fight at the moment. They're holding on right now.
This
Dara
is
2-2,
just
40
really
seconds.
Nice. Yeah, this is just a fight for their lives right now. Dara 2-2 are trying to save this card as much as they can.
This is
with
the last
minds.
Push for SNSD. This is their reputation, their unbeaten record on the line here. And it's not going well so far. Tech has taken down two people. They're still trying to get this level 1 sentry down. It's not working. Tech is just still standing there. He's Tweak snipes with a close range headshot. Hurry tries to get on the cart. He can't do anything. I don't think they're going to get
left.
This. I don't think
no,
they're
going to
get
this. No, this is not going to happen right now. They're already at Dara 2-2 to set up their defenses. It's level 1 still holding that ground. They're trying to push in. Alex goes down as well. Quite a nice work there. And ladies and gentlemen, history is being made. Dara 2-2 won with SNSD finals and the prize pot of €550, I do believe. This is finals. SNSD got beaten for the first time.
Wow. Well, I've been waiting for this moment for 2 years to see SNSD lose an official. But Dara 2-2, you have to give Dara 2-2 all the credit for the way they played in that game. They were the underdogs.
They played fantastic. I was like, I think SNSD just underestimated Dara 2-2 today because they had a hard fight last week with Pirate Gapers, Dara 2-2, and they just thought, okay, so if they had some problems with Pirate Gapers, we're going to have a nice afternoon walk. They did not. SNSD just got absolutely beaten with nice pushes, nice teamwork, even though K3 was going down quite a lot. They managed to just push this card without Ubers.
It's the aggression that they showed that not many teams in Europe have ever shown, but Dara2-2 have done it. They've beaten SNSD. It took them, you know, it took them 4 seasons to lose, but they finally lost. And AOX's last game as well. It's a bit sad, but don't take anything away from the way SNSD have dominated European Highlander
for so long. So right now, ladies and gentlemen, Dara2-2, new champions of ETF2L. Season 4 is theirs, first place in Premier Division. Congratulations, Dara2-2, almighty Frenchman.
They do actually win the prize money. That was at the start of the season as well. I can't remember how much it is, though.
I think it's 550 euros. So it's quite a lot, I have to say. It's quite a lot of money, and it's been split between players. So, well, you know, they can buy themselves new mouses, new headsets, just whatever they want. Maybe new keys, unusuals. They can basically stock up on keys right now and wait for the Season 5 to come up.
Yeah, that's what I would do. Actually, no, I'd probably spend my money on beer. Yeah, that is an end of an era for Highlander. SNSD's dominance over. It kind of reminds me when Dignitas lost in sixes. But
well, you know, it's at the same time, it's kind of sad to see SNSD lose 2-0. Actually, I thought it was going to be the third map as well, but we didn't get to see that. Dara2-2 won with really nice.
Just before we wrap everything up, Jake, won your man of the match. I think that play by Exxon was really, really huge.
Definitely.
Where he managed to drop Sucker with Uber advantage. It's sort of just, SDC just didn't watch the flank. It's just that simple, really. And it has cost him the map and the championship. But your man
Definitely.
Of the match.
I think, yeah, Exxon is probably the best man of the match from both teams, because he basically saved his team so many times by attacking the soccer war when he wasn't expecting that, and basically allowing his team to have this really nice advantage that later on they could use it for whatever they wanted, basically. So really excellent, nice work there. Also both Spies, Hari and Daff, were working on combo on upward especially. They didn't show anything in particular on Badwater, but upward it was definitely their map to play on.
Yeah, well, I agree, Exxon did really, really well over the two maps, but I think I'll give it to Tech there as my man of the match, the way he played. I think the way he sort of led pushes and the way he responded to his medic going down, to advantages that he got. So
exactly.
I'll give that to Tech. Do you want to plug your stream a bit before we wrap this up, or
yes,
anything else to say?
I would like to thank a lot for Blackout Gaming for sponsoring Season 4 of Highlander ETF2L. They've done a lot of work. They promoted Highlander in Europe pretty well, and on every stream is about 100-150 people. It's really nice to see a new site growing up so fast. I'm really happy to be the part of it, of course, with John here, who is basically streaming every single match that is going on. And of course, thank you very much, you, Hildre, for joining me today. It was a pleasure casting of you, because you are quite a person for a Highlander in the whole world, actually.
Thank you. It means a lot to come from my favorite Polish/British caster.
That mistake is never going to leave me. It's like, I saved that. I screenshot that mistake, and it's just going to be my trophy from today's match, where Dara2-2 just won with SNSD.
Yeah, well, big night, big change for European Highlander, the beginning of a new era. But for me here on Team Fortress TV, I'm gonna sort of wrap things up. Coming up in about 5 minutes, which is, I think, is
yes,
this big I-49 show match. Now the idea is to, you know, raise awareness and raise some money to help get High Roller Gaming's, the American ESEA Invite Champions, over to I-49, which is happening on the weekend of August the 22nd or 23rd, I can't remember which, of this year. And they're going to try and conquer Europe again. I mean, American
They lost last early. I mean, they won last year with Europeans. So definitely Europeans will try to beat Americans this time.
Yeah, there's going to be a lot more tryharding this time from the Europeans. And they're, of course, playing Epsilon, the current champions of Europe, in the show match. And that's going to be over on Team Fortress TV, the main stream. We're on Team Fortress TV 2, the secondary stream. So switch over to that when it goes live in a minute. And your casters for the evening should be Seabear, Greg, and on the stream should be Chameleon tonight. So please go over to Team Fortress TV in a few minutes when it starts going live. And enjoy the night. I'm going to wrap it up and say thank you, Jake, for casting and being the man to commentate on the final moments of SNSD's ETF 2L crown. Good night.
Good night. Thank you very much.
Brace yourself.